San Diego, California is known as a laid-back city where the sand, the surf, and water sports are just a part of city life. But today at Qualcomm Stadium, sand and dirt has been molded into more than castles on the beach, and the jumps aren't just off the back of a Pacific Ocean wave. It's time for high-flying, high-horsepower stadium off-road racing as we bring you round four of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series on the NBC Sports Network. Hello, everyone. I'm Brian Till, and welcome to today's coverage. Joining me up top is Motorsports Insider and broadcaster Chuck Howard, as well as Kelly Stavis, trackside. Now, after three rounds in the inaugural season, the points look like this. Rob McCracken holding on to the slimmest of championship leads, Chuck.
Well, Brian, Rob Mack was our winner in Phoenix. Robbie Gordon, though, he's been on fire. Winner 2 weeks ago in L.A., won qualifying here in San Diego. Justin Lofton looking to overtake both of those guys here in San Diego tonight.
Yeah, Lofton and P.J. Jones having a good battle for third. And for more on Justin Lofton, here's Kelly.
Brian, even though Rob McCracken and Robbie Gordon are neck and neck for the championship lead, don't count out Justin Lofton. The NASCAR truck driver sits third in the point standings and has proven to be just as quick, if not quicker, than the guys he trails. He was our fastest qualifier at the season opener in Phoenix, but his results haven't always reflected his talent. Even though he won at Long Beach, he finished 11th in Phoenix and 9th in Los Angeles. Now, with a quarter of the season already behind us, Justin says he's definitely looking at those points, and he wants to be more consistent. He said he's got to take less of a Ricky Bobby if you're not first or last approached. Now, Justin has just arrived in San Diego from a desert race out in Nevada. Now, the good news for him is that he won his class. It was a great day. The bad news is he's already raced more than 100 miles, and he admits he's tired, and there's certainly no room for error here in San Diego. So we'll see if fatigue plays a factor for Lofton tonight.
Well, thanks, Kelly. Justin Lofton certainly has his work cut out for him. Trucks already heading into the stadium. If you're new to the Super Truck Series, here is what is in store today. Each weekend of competition, qualifying sets the field for the first of two heat races, with the top three in each heat moving directly to the main event. And then all the other finishers in each heat will meet in a last chance qualifying race. That will set the remainder of the field for the final event. $40,000 to the winner of tonight's event. $500,000 goes to the series champion. And heat number one about to get underway. It'll be Ari Leyendyk who brings the field down. This is how they will start. Notice Robbie Gordon at the back. He was the pole sitter, Chuck, but what does that get you?
You go back to the last place to start the heat number one, but that's what makes this stuff fun.
It's an inverted order here. So Robbie Gordon, the quickest of the drivers here in this heat. Ari Leyendyk, the slowest. You also saw the 21 orange number plate. Mike McCracken in, and we're green. We're racing heat number one underway. Hold on. Through the first of the crossover jumps, the Pro Comp crossover, Leyendyk leads the field.
Well, Ari Leyendyk won heat number one in L.A. 2 weeks ago, got out front. He took a different turn, as did Justin Lofton, taking that crossover right there, but Ari building a lead.
You've got the Toyo crossover jump, or you can opt for the West Coast sand pit, and now
and that's a San Diego traffic jam right there, Brian.
You got to come back down and get the truck down the chute, over the step up, and now the next of two options into the hairpin. Leyendyk chooses the tighter inside option. Ward right behind him, and here we go again.
And Mike Jenkins taking the lead as he goes over that step up, but look out, Justin Lofton in the Solar City white and green truck right on his tail.
Jeff Ward got the worst of all of this as Mike Jenkins now gets shoved out of the way by Justin Lofton. Lofton takes the lead, and he'll lead at the end of the first lap and over the Pro Comp crossover.
Yes, indeed. And everybody safely through that turn heading up the Pro Comp crossover. Yesterday in practice, there was a lot of concern that folks were going to have trouble, but everybody safely through.
Lofton taking the Pro Comp crossover, takes the jump, and a problem for Robbie Gordon, who has spun on track, but not for Justin Lofton. Now down the chute, trouble everywhere. Guys trying to get a handle on this track, but Lofton takes the outside at the hairpin. Rob McCracken takes the inside option, and now comes the rhythm section side by side.
That's a good old-fashioned drag race there. And earlier in the show, you heard Kelly mention that Justin Lofton raced earlier in the day, but he's not showing any signs so far of any fatigue.
Well, so did Rob McCachran right behind him. So these two drivers already warmed up, let's say. But they are exhausted. They both take the right-hand option and through the West Coast sand pit.
Absolutely. Up and over goes Lofton, heading to the second step up. Going to make that sharp turn, heading down the chute. A good battle at the top of the field right here.
Kelly.
Well, it seemed that Justin Lofton had some time to get settled in here from his race in Nevada. Rob McCachran arrived just moments before the start of this heat race. He'll compete in seven different off-road vehicles this year. He said every time he gets into one, it takes him about 5 minutes to sort of locate the ignition switch, locate the shifter, go through the motions before he feels like he's at home again. Well, I'm not even sure if he had 5 minutes before the start of this heat race.
I'll tell you what, he and Justin Lofton are having quite the go of it, and now McCachran has taken the right-hand option, and Lofton has gone over the Toyo crossover, I should say, and they come out bumper to bumper down the chute.
And surprised to see so many drivers taking that Toyo crossover tonight, Brian, because yesterday in practice, pretty much nobody wanted to do it.
And now they split him again at the hairpin. McCachran in the inside in that silver and blue tracks his truck. Lofton in the white takes the lead again, but this is the way they've run lap after lap. Solar City on board the side of that truck, the SST for Justin Lofton, and over the Pro Comp crossover. You ride on board, you see him grab that handbrake, Chuck, that locks the rear brakes, helps him turn the truck.
Absolutely, you can use your foot pedal, but these guys, when they hit that turn, like to use that handbrake to whip that rear end around.
And one more time, they've taken different options. Lofton still in front of McCachran, but it's close.
One of the biggest surprises in this field, Brian, is Sheldon Creed, number 74, a 15-year-old high school student from California, has over 20 first-place finishes in off-road racing. He's racing the big boys tonight, qualified third, and holding his own so far.
Yeah, he's third, and your shot right there, running just behind Justin Lofton and Rob McCachran, and you cannot say enough for this young man, doing a great job. Like you said, 15 years old. I talked to him earlier, he said, I just got my learner's permit the other day, but I got to tell you, I think I drive better in the race truck than I do on the street right now.
Well, let's watch him take the Toyo crossover, and he lands it cleanly.
Like a pro, and the battle still raging on in front. Justin Lofton in the white Solar City SST. One more time, he and Rob McCachran split the options down at the hairpin. McCachran always comes out in front, but Justin Lofton gets the run off the corner.
Brian, we talked about Sheldon Creed, the future, the youth of this series, but let's talk about Jeff Ward. We all know about his accolades from his years of motocross and supercross, and right there in the number four Stadium Super Truck, Jeff Ward, having a pretty good run tonight, fourth place right now.
Well, and Ward has been fast all year long. He just hasn't had good luck. A fourth at Phoenix, then eighth at Long Beach, 12th at the Coliseum when he had a flat tire. So he's been quick, as you would expect that he would, but he just needs to get Lady Luck on his side.
Robbie Gordon in fifth position. He won the pole position, if you will, here in San Diego on Friday. And Robbie got hung up earlier in this heat race, digging in there, hanging in there in fifth, but he doesn't seem to be gaining much ground on Jeff Ward.
Well, he gained ground on Rob McCachran with his victory last time out at the Coliseum. And Gordon needs to close a little bit. He picked up a point for being on the pole. You mentioned that earlier, but he's lagging back that problem early, as you said, being shown in fifth right now. It's Lofton, McCachran, and Creed, then Ward, with seven laps in the books right now.
Well, back up front as they head down the chute, it's Justin Lofton.
And look at Sheldon Creed. He is right there, really closing in on our two leaders.
Well, what a dream this must be for this kid. Thinking of in that cockpit, if you will, seeing Rob McCachran right ahead and Justin Lofton. Oh, but
Creed.
Trouble.
Creed out of the ballpark, comes off of the hairpin, gets up on the concrete barrier, and literally flies out of the track. And there is no way for him to get back in, Chuck. That's the problem.
And folks, if these guys aren't impeding the racetrack at all, we're not going to see a caution. But what a disappointing way to end Sheldon Creed's debut tonight. But folks knew he was here, and he'll have a chance to come back in the last chance qualifier.
Just got crossed up on the step up into the rhythm section, got up on that concrete barrier and out of the ballpark. You ride with Lofton. You see him grab the handbrake there to help turn the truck as he now heads through the rhythm section. Well, past the ProComp crossover and then over the steel ramp.
Well, there was not much rhythm left to that area down there, Brian, but here comes Justin Lofton, one lap to go.
White flag out, Lofton over the crossover, and a pretty hard landing.
Almost went over on that landing.
And he takes the left-hand option, McCaffrey taking the right-hand option, seeing if he can do anything. It's pretty much the way they've run it all night tonight. And one more time, McCaffrey will be right there on the back bumper, but not close enough to do anything as Lofton heads down the chute for the last time.
Well, in practice here at San Diego, Brian, the drivers weren't taking that Toyo crossover too much, but it looks like tonight that's going to be your way to gain on the rest of the field, or at the very least, stay out in front like Justin Lofton has as he heads to the checkered flag.
Lofton around the last corner. He'll return to victory circle. Justin Lofton claims heat number one here in San Diego. Congratulations to Justin Lofton for his heat win in number one. Rob McCaffrey right behind him, though. It was close. Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks on NBC. Heat two coming up. Make sure you don't miss a lap. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Qualcomm Stadium. Brian Till and Chuck Howard with you. And earlier we talked about the championship. And Chuck, I think the thing that's important to note is these drivers have multiple ways to score points on the weekend.
I'll say there's a myriad of ways to win points here at the Stadium Super Trucks. 25 points to win the main event. You can also garner 1 point by winning the qualifying session on Friday. 3 points by leading the most laps. And we've got a real cool thing here. It's called passing points. You get a point for every position you gain in the main event. So that's pretty cool.
Number two about to get underway, and up front it'll be Justin Matney in the number eight. Matney will lead the field off, and Ricky Johnson way back in the back in his yellow number five. Johnson not able to qualify, and that had to be disappointing for him because he's another one of those drivers like Jeff Ward, whom we talked about earlier. Very quick, just bad luck.
Absolutely. Here we go. Green flag. Heat number two. Matney leading him to the green flag.
To the green flag, and a little problem behind. Adrian Chinney in that bright orange number 10 gets hung up, but PJ Jones says, thank you very much, I'll go by, and Matney takes the right-hand option. PJ Jones around the left side option, the Toyo crossover, and they should meet down at the far end. Jones trying to close down. You see him coming out of the corner of the screen there, and Matney with a problem. He shoots wide, Jones is wide, and Adrian Chinney.
Another California traffic jam into some serious contact in the back of the field as Johnson and Nick Baumgartner got together.
And right now, Adrian Chinney on the outside option, PJ Jones the inside option, through the rhythm section, and they are rubbing. And you ride on board with Ricky Johnson over the steel jump.
Absolutely. Here's Ricky Johnson. As you can see, as Brian mentioned in the previous heat, that handbrake these guys use as they make these turns to whip that back end around. Adrian Chinney slow, but he makes it over. But again, in car with Ricky Johnson. What an awesome view that is.
Johnson trying to chase down the 77 right in front of him. That is Jarrett Brooks, the other 15-year-old in the field.
And Jarrett Brooks, 15 years old, More on that young man as we go on here in heat number two.
Look at PJ Jones leading right now, right behind him. Jarrett Brooks beginning to close the distance. And there's Ricky Johnson in that bright yellow Jegs truck. There's Jarrett. And you're really kind of going to school on PJ Jones in front of him right now. Johnson hanging in there, and you got to take your hat off to Ricky Johnson. He was doing some instructing for the U.S. military, trying to help them with some of their off-road skills, and that's about all we'll say there, just except for the fact that RJ wasn't here the last couple of days, so he is learning right now as he drives, as he races. PJ Jones out in front, then Jarrett Brooks, then Ricky Johnson. That is your top three. Brooks by Johnson.
And P.J. Jones, last 2 weeks ago in Los Angeles, a heat winner. And this guy is getting better each and every week as he heads through the rhythm section, heads down the fast portion of that chute, taking the metal ramp, and he whips it around as we continue on here in heat number two.
Well, we joked about P.J. being on his head more than any other driver, but you said it. He's really gotten a handle on these stadium super trucks. Found a victory in a heat race, running well here. So is Jarrett Brooks. You cannot say enough about this young man.
Well, as I mentioned, 15 years old, just like Sheldon Creed. He's out of California, has his driver's permit, but no license. And he's run a lot of off-road, and he's hanging in there and putting on a heck of a show all the way up to second place, Jarrett Brooks of the Symmetry Electric Stadium Super Truck.
Oh, and a little bicycle there around the outside. Ricky Johnson takes the position back, but only for a moment. And Brooks back in the throttle, 650 horsepower, trying to get that to the ground. And Johnson now right behind him, a little wipe of the visor there so we can see. Back on the bumper of Jarrett Brooks.
Nick Baumgartner back in the field as he tries to track down Justin Matney, and Baumgartner in fifth position. And Nick is another one of these guys, kind of like PJ Jones, who is constantly and kind of gotten better each and every week. The number 12 Pure Michigan truck of Nick Baumgartner.
Certainly no fear on the part of Baumgartner. He is a Winter X Games snowboard cross driver and very experienced, very brave, and a problem on the racetrack. The red is out.
Well, what happened, and we'll see it, I think, in a minute here, Brian, but Lalu Laguna had some trouble with the Toyo crossover. As you can see, that visitormexico.com, the front end of that vehicle, he's going to have to head back to the pits.
Trucks lined up. It's PJ Jones leading right now, and that impressive 15-year-old Jarrett Brooks right behind him, and we'll go back to green. They'll come through the rhythm section, and they'll get the green flag as they come back around to the first of the crossovers.
And the green flag is out, and PJ Jones, as I mentioned earlier on, getting better each and every week. Heat winner in Los Angeles 2 weeks ago. And this is another driver in this series, Brian, a guy that can drive anything. He's run NASCAR Sprint Cups, had a top 10 finish in NASCAR Nationwide, sports car winner. He's raced in Baja, and all those years of experience pretty much racing everything paying off as PJ Jones still out P1.
And look at Ricky Johnson in that yellow Jegs machine, trying to move forward, trying to get back past Jarrett Brooks, the impressive youngster right there in the white 77 in front, running second. It's Jones, Brooks, Johnson, and then Matney, who started on the pole. Justin Matney in the black number 8. And look at this, PJ Jones and Ricky Johnson banging doors. And Jones, a slide job.
And that is some fantastic racing. And we saw from the in-car camera, Ricky Johnson took that hairpin turn and gained some advantage. But PJ Jones has a pretty fast race truck.
PJ Jones comfortably in the lead.
Yes, indeed. Ricky Johnson right there. And it looks like PJ can just kind of cruise home now as he's on the final lap, heading down the chute. Ricky Johnson still in second. And just Justin Matney hanging in there in third place. So it looks like he's going to have a nice starting spot for the main as well.
And that's big for Matney. He needed a good finish. As PJ Jones through the rhythm section one last time. Matney working his way around. It's still Jones, Johnson, and Matney. Jones just one more corner across the line, and it will be PJ Jones wins heat number two in San Diego.
Two races in a row. It's PJ Jones. And that's got to be huge for his confidence, building more and more. Third place finish for PJ at the LA Coliseum. And, you know, a guy that many folks thought maybe not, might not be a threat to win this $500,000 season-ending championship. He's going to be right there in the thick of things if he keeps running like that, Brian.
For the second race weekend in a row, PJ Jones wins a heat race in the Stadium Super Truck Series. Question is, when will he win a main event? We'll find out if he can do it from here at Qualcomm. Plenty more to come. Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks is brought to you by Procomp, off-road driven. By Traxxas, the fastest name in radio control. And by Speed Energy, a healthier, faster choice of energy. Fuel the need. With both heat races done, it's time for last chance qualifier. Here's how they lined up to start. Robbie Gordon on pole.
We're not supposed to see Robbie Gordon second in the points heading in the last chance qualifier, but there he was.
There he was, and you see the number 74, the black truck, being driven by Sheldon Creed, a 15-year-old. He was impressive. Nick Baumgartner having a good run. Ari Lyon-Dyke Jr., but it was Robbie Gordon having it all his way out in front.
Yeah, absolutely. He got out front early, pretty much stayed there.
Mike Jenkins with a problem on one of the inside options, but Adrian Chinney, turtle.
Yeah, the wild man with some serious problems for sure.
The guy that did not have a problem was Robbie Gordon from the drop of the green. He was strong. Lyon Dyke Jr. had a good run. But in the end, Robbie Gordon around the final corner takes the checker flag and takes the victory in the LCQ.
The LCQ setting position 7 through 14 for the main event.
Yeah, because remember the top three in each of the heats, they go directly to the final. Everybody else gets set by the LCQ, but then a little twist. See the four Traxxas bodies, they turn them over. There's a number. Well, number four today. That means the top four positions get inverted. If you were on the pole, you're going to start fourth, and that's exactly what happens. So when you take a look at the grid and how they'll start for the main event, Ricky Johnson starts from the pole.
And you mentioned PJ Jones and Justin Lofton, they won their heat races. It gets flip-flopped, so they start three and four.
And Rob McCachran, championship points leader, starts outside the front row. We talked about Sheldon Creed, Jarrett Brooks, another 15-year-old.
Add their ages up, doesn't even match Robbie Gordon's 44.
Yeah, impressive stuff. Stadium Super Trucks, but remember, when you come to a Stadium Super Truck event, you also get trophy carts and super buggies. Well, trophy carts always putting on a great show. Miles Cheeks in the number one. A good run out in front, and there is always action, let's say, in trophy carts. Everybody walked away and had a great day. The guy with the best day, Miles Cheeks. He takes the victory, second of the season. He also won back at Phoenix, and so big celebrations from Miles Cheek. From trophy carts to super buggies, 1600cc four-cylinder engines, about 200 horsepower, and some excitement from the get-go. The number 48 up on the wall, that's Rick Welch. Bad day for him. And throughout the rest of the field, I mean, these guys pushing, banging, shoving, and throwing lots and lots of dirt. Take a look at this. Excuse me.
Throwing lots of dirt, and these guys put on a great show as well. See?
Another upside down. That was Rob Archibald with the problem, but in the end, the checker flag falls on the number 12. So a good victory for Abdali Lopez. A winner in Super Buggy. Super Buggy, trophy carts. Well, guess what's next? You got it. Bigfoot Monster Trucks from Qualcomm Stadium. They're up next when we come back. Stadium Super Trucks on the NBC Sports Network. Stick around. Look out over San Diego Bay here in San Diego. Round four of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series underway, and great to be out here on the West Coast. The scenery absolutely beautiful, and the people as well. Super buggies trophy carts and Bigfoot monster trucks. The main event, Eric Swanson, only 17 years old, up against one of the best in the business, Dan Runty.
So we have a youngster in the series going up against one of the biggest veterans, one of the most well-known guys in Bigfoot monster truck racing, Dan Runty. But what a huge night for that youngster, Eric Swanson.
Look at that. Great jump by Swanson. Runty actually holds the distance record, a world record for jumping one of these monster trucks. And in the end, it was one final jump for Runty. Takes the victory as Eric Swanson has some type of a problem and is stopped there on course. A one-lap run, and Dan Runty takes the victory. Impressive stuff, though, for Swanson. 1,500 horsepower, 11,000 pounds.
And he's 17 years old. Good job.
Good job. We'll see more of him, that's for sure. And you'll see more Stadium Super Trucks. Take a look at the remaining schedule for 2013. Next race? Well, we're right back here in San Diego.
Next week, going to do it again, but with a different track, folks. And, hey, Nation's Heartland, Stadium Super Trucks coming your way. St. Louis, June 8th, and Soldier Field. For the first time in over 30 years, a motorsports event will be held in Soldier Field. So, folks, be a part of history.
And no better place to wrap it all up than Sam Boyd Stadium in Las Vegas in November. I'm sure there'll be a bit of a banquet and a celebration there.
You're already looking forward to it, aren't you?
I'm definitely looking forward to it. I mean, think about the exciting things we've seen and the exciting things we will see. You're going to see something exciting. The main event up next from Qualcomm Stadium, Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks. Main event coming your way.
Welcome back to Qualcomm Stadium in San Diego for round four of Stadium Super Trucks, the main event just moments away. And we've got some great news. At the back of the field, you will see number 17, Lala Laguna. He had a nasty crash in his heat race when his brakes locked up going off the front jump. He came up short. There was damage to the truck. It looked like there was damage to Lala, but I saw moments later he was actually out of his truck and smiling back in the paddock. His crew, hard at work, they had a fix. A broken lower control arm, the suspension, and some damage to the front cage, but they got it all back together in time to have him out here for the main event. So Lala Laguna all smiles as he heads into this main event, Brian.
Well, thanks, Kelly. That's good news for Lala Laguna to be back in. It'll be interesting to see if that truck is in good shape to race with. This is how they'll line up. Ricky Johnson, Rob McCracken on the front row. That's some strength there, Chuck.
There's some veterans there, a lot of victories, but I'm going to keep an eye on Justin Lofton, of course. He's red hat hot, wants to get back on the podium with a victory. And of course, those passing points.
Well, absolutely. Robbie Gordon in the seven truck, back in seventh. You look through this top seven, there is some serious talent there. Look a little further back. The first of our 15-year-olds, Sheldon Creed in eighth, Jarrett Brooks, they're going to be eighth and ninth, and those two spectacular in their debut. Struggled a little bit, made some rookie mistakes, let's say.
Mistakes late, but I'm going to keep my eye on those guys, and Creed, I think, has a really good truck, and Brooks, they both showed very well in their heat races, so keep an eye on those guys.
On board with Justin Lofton, he'll bring us some good looks. There's Robbie Gordon, and it'll be Ricky Johnson who leads the field to green, and here we go, the final, the main event. From here in San Diego, Qualcomm Stadium, Ricky Johnson across the line, and we are racing. Be interesting to see who selects it. Ricky Johnson goes right, and you saw Rob McCracken go left at that first option. They're going to come back together here as McCracken comes over the Toyo crossover. They should come back together. Ricky Johnson holds on to the lead. BJ Jones gets tagged by Justin Lofton. And already down the chute, things getting busy.
Yeah, Ricky Johnson took that outside lane through the sand pits. And as we saw in the heat races, it appeared that the Toyo crossover was just a little bit quicker. But Ricky Johnson has a pretty quick race truck in that yellow Jegs number 5.
Very quick, and a problem for one of the other competitors. I believe it's the 77, Jared Brooks, coming to the start-finish line, but it did not impede Ricky Johnson. And Rob McCracken is giving chase big time. That orange number panel signifying he leads the championship, but it's Ricky Johnson that leads the race.
And McCracken taking that Toyo crossover again, and Johnson getting through the sand pits, increasing that lead.
Wow, Rob McCracken using every bit of road down at the hairpin. Johnson with the inside option. McCracken's going to take a little bicycle there by McCracken. And Johnson just pulling out a little bits at a time, a problem. You saw further back, P.J. Jones in the black 98. Justin Lofton on the move forward.
Right there in the back of the field, P.J. Jones winning his heat race, trying to get onto the back bumper of Justin Lofton as they head to the Toyo crossover.
Lofton in his Solar City truck over the jump, over the crossover. P.J. Jones a short distance back, that black 98. Remember, he won heat number 2. And was that Matney that he just went past that had a problem? Yeah, Justin Matney with a problem on the backside of the course. Jones trying to claw down on Justin Lofton down the chute.
Yeah, it doesn't appear that Jones is making much ground on him, but he's staying right there. And right there he makes some ground on him as they hit the hairpin. And now heading through the rhythm section as Lofton caught some serious air off that one jump heading into the rhythm section.
PJ not afraid to lean on him at all. That fiberglass and Kevlar reinforced bodywork really starting to put it on the back of Lofton. Robbie Gordon closing in on that duo as well.
Robbie starting 7th in this main event here. He doesn't seem to be gaining much ground, but he did win the last chance qualifier, which I know shows that he's got a decent race truck.
Even Gordon talking about this is a tough layout. He said, I may have made this one a little too difficult. The other thing to note, this main a lot longer than any of the heat races. 20 laps, and it is physically abusing. The guy's saying this has been the most difficult track as far as physical goes. It really wears you out, and they're going to have to do 20 laps.
Well, with this track and at Qualcomm, it's a tight confine, the tightest track we've had so far this season, and so these guys don't have any chance to take a break.
Ricky Johnson leading over Rob McCracken, then Lofton, P.J. Jones, Robbie Gordon. That is the top 5 with 4 laps in the books, and there's a look at your leader.
Ricky Johnson, just unbelievable. Didn't make it here for qualifying, but he's leading this thing. Didn't see this racetrack till today.
Well, and that's what's impressive. We missed that yellow number 5, the Jegs truck, in practice. It, as you said, he didn't get to see the track, and that's the mark of somebody who's done what Ricky Johnson has done, whether it was on a motorcycle or in a race car. He is a champion. He's smart. He read the track, and man, he is fast today, Kelly.
He told me afterward that once he found out just how tough this track was and how physically demanding, he said, forget this. I don't want any part of that last chance qualifier.
And a good call. I mean, you want to be as fresh as you possibly can, which is impressive when you think about Justin Lofton running in 3rd. Remember, he won a race earlier today, an off-road race through the desert, a 300-mile race, sharing driving duties with some family members. But still, a lot of travel for Justin Lofton, and he's hanging in there in 3rd. But McCracken and Ricky Johnson have pulled away. There's Justin Lofton.
Yeah, Justin in that Solar City sponsored number 6 truck. And Justin hanging in there in 3rd position, but doesn't seem to be making up much ground on Rob McCracken.
Things clean through the first 6 laps here, and that's been amazing because there's been a lot of problems on this tight racetrack here at Qualcomm Stadium. You ride on board with Justin Lofton, shifting gears, he'll grab the brake as he comes to this next corner, locks the rear tires for just an instant, helps the truck turn, and then 650 horsepower back to the ground.
And there's Rob McCracken in that Traxxas number 21, grinding and doing it. And I mean, that guy, as you see the stat right there, has won 20 championships in his racing career, including off-road, motocross, and you name it. Two of the sports premier drivers right here on NBC Sports Network. So enjoy it, folks.
Think about Rob McCracken, over 200 victories. He is right there on the back of Ricky Johnson, that silver and blue Traxxas truck, number 21, Rob McCracken. And there is Lala Laguna, the number 17, Visit Mexico truck. We saw the problems for Laguna earlier. We talked about it just a little while ago. Great to see him back even in a truck after the hard hit when he came up short on that Toyo crossover.
Yeah, and we don't know what if he just seemed like he just got the air knocked out of him. And we hear from the pits that he lost his brakes when he was jumping over the Toyo crossover. And we've got caution out on the speedway.
Caution for the first time with seven laps in the books. We'll take a quick break from Qualcomm Stadium, but we'll be back to more Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks right after this. Flies again here in the main event. Ricky Johnson leads the field, but this time it's Robbie Gordon right behind him. Rob McCachran in third, and Gordon is putting pressure on from the drop of the green.
And PJ Jones hanging in there, won his heat earlier on. He decides to follow Ricky Johnson this time, and I think for the first time in this main event, Johnson up and over the Toyo crossover.
Yeah, Johnson went left, took the Toyo crossover. It didn't work for anyone else. It doesn't work for him, and Robbie Gordon goes to the lead. Ricky Johnson back to second. Rob McCachran holds on to third, and Johnson has to be thinking, why did I just do that? I was so successful with the right-hand option. Why did I change?
And now the in-car from Ricky Johnson. And he's got a windshield full of that orange number 7 Speed Energy of Robbie Gordon as Robbie heads up and over the Pro Comp.
Big championship implications here. Gordon just a single marker back after qualifying from Rob McCachran in the championship. And now he's two positions out in front, and he has passed several trucks to get there. So we'll get points for those as well. Robbie Gordon having an evening of it. It'll be interesting to see. Ricky Johnson has been so quick. Can he shake off that error in judgment? I say error in judgment. Now, you try anything as a race car driver to get a position, but can he calm back down and charge back to the front?
It may not have been an error in judgment. It may have just been a really good move by Robbie Gordon.
Well, there you go. Good point. McCachran slipping back just a little bit. Rob McCachran, another one of those drivers, ran the Silver State 300. He and Justin Lofton did. And they have to be fatigued. They have to be tired. Not only the race, but the travel to and from. He's doing a good job of holding on. Gordon maintains about the same lead that he had before as you look at PJ Jones running fourth right now.
And PJ appeared he was going to gain on Rob McCachran at that restart, but he's lost a little ground. But hanging in there nonetheless, going to be a decent points night for PJ.
Well, we've talked about the improvement that PJ has shown over the first three rounds. He showed even more improvement by winning a heat race here. The second heat, now running well into the top five. So PJ really good getting a handle on these stadium super trucks. Look at it pick up that right front as he goes around the horseshoe on the way to the Pro Comp crossover.
Rob McCachran in third position, trailing Ricky Johnson as Robbie Gordon continues to increase his lead on Ricky Johnson. But Rob trying to do everything he can. Big Mac trying to get back up in there. But as of right now, it'll be a podium finish for Mac.
And a driver not having the day that he wanted is Justin Lofton, who just pulled out of the stadium. As you look at Rob McCachran still trying to hold on. And McCachran's such a veteran, has won so many times. He knows how to win a championship. And I'm thinking that right now he may be saying, I've got a third place truck. I'm going to leave here with those third place points. I'm certainly not going to give those away by throwing this away.
Well, last lap by, Ricky Johnson was the quickest, trying to gain on Robbie. And it appears that perhaps he is gaining slightly.
He's going to have to close down a lot more as they head down the chute. Beginning to pull out PJ Jones, trying to close in on the back of Rob Mack. And there's Robbie Gordon.
Well, as we mentioned at the top of the show as well, Brian, Robbie's been simply red hot. Started off in Phoenix, not getting the victory. But 2 weeks ago at the L.A. Coliseum, Robbie getting the win, was on the pole here, and right now out in front. Ari Lyandike Jr., haven't mentioned his name too much, currently in fifth position. And Ari's another guy like P.J. Jones that slowly but surely is hanging in there and has performed very well, with the exception of the main at the L.A. Coliseum 2 weeks ago. Ari did win a heat race, so he's getting the hang of this stuff as well.
Yeah, from a guy who is a sports car and open-wheel driver to dirt, he's doing a great job. Talk about a great job. Oh, and Gordon almost had a problem out on track as we're looking at Ari Lyandike. And Ricky Johnson has closed within 0.3 of a second the last time by, and he may be even closer This time it was 2.1 seconds the last time at the line. 1.4 this time. Johnson can smell blood in the water, and Gordon trying to get past Lalo Laguna had an upset moment, and it allowed Ricky Johnson to close in even more. I said it was not a good evening for Justin Lofton. Kelly, what did he have?
Certainly not the way he wanted to end things after winning his heat race. Justin, we saw you get over on your lid early on. What happened?
Basically, just the track was coming up in some of the areas, got in the corner too hard. It's real unfortunate for everyone on the Solar City team. We had a decent run going. We weren't the fastest truck out there, but we definitely didn't deserve this. I think we broke an axle or something, and track is tough. I mean, it's fun, and it's going to be real abusive on equipment.
Thanks, Justin. Brian.
Well, yeah, not the 91, and remember, he had a great run with a victory, and you look at Ricky Johnson just sideways, and Lofton really had closed down in the championship, didn't have a good run at the Coliseum, and now struggled again here, and not of his own making, but that is off-road racing. It's punishing to both man and machine, and Justin Lofton got the worst of it here. Gordon kind of beginning to pull out again, and it was traffic that helped create that gap. Adrian Chinney was in between Gordon and Ricky Johnson the last lap, and it really allowed Gordon to pull out a little bit over Johnson. It'll be interesting to see. Ricky can close it back down. 16 laps down, 4 to go.
Well, it looks like Robbie's really getting into a good rhythm right here. And as you mentioned, Ricky Johnson got tied up with Adrian Chinney. That's where he lost some time in that sand pit. And you wonder at this stage of the evening now if Ricky Johnson, if fatigue is setting in.
Johnson pushing as hard as he can. Now putting pressure on Ricky Johnson. Johnson with a big bicycle, and they get hung up. And oh, PJ Jones just on the outside lane. He goes over, and PJ Jones has become a turtle.
And another caution as Robbie had a huge lead, and what a huge break for Johnson and McEachran because of PJ Jones' misfortune, however.
How do you get past Robbie Gordon? We're about to find out. The green flag flies, and here we go.
Yeah, I'd have to think he's gonna just try whatever Robbie does, he does, until maybe the final lap, but just gamble, and maybe he'll take the Toyo crossover on lap with the final lap to go.
Through the first crossover, and here's decision time. Gordon out with a bit of a bicycle. The first four trucks go right, and Gordon with a near miss there as he got the big bicycle going through that right-hand option, and Ricky Johnson stays right with him. Rob McEachran in third. Down the chute, into the hairpin, inside option for Gordon, for Johnson, and McEachran. It's follow the leader.
And what a treat for off-road racing fans, folks. Look at that. Robbie Gordon on top as Rob Mack almost lost it in third place, but hung on to it.
The rhythm section doesn't have a lot of rhythm to it right now. It's getting really rutted up, and McEachran drops back a little bit. But Ricky Johnson still trying to hold on to the back of Robbie Gordon. Time is slipping away, 17 laps down. 20 laps in this main event, and if Johnson's going to get something done, he needs to get it done soon.
Well, I'd have to think, like I mentioned, he's going to have to gamble with one lap to go because Robbie's obviously going to take that sand pit every time.
Well, you got to think Gordon will take
Robbie
the inside.
Has
Gordon with a problem in the hairpin, and Johnson by Gordon up on the K-rail, and Ricky Johnson slips by Gordon back to third.
Well, that's a mistake that you would never think you'd see a veteran like Robbie do.
So rutted up down there in the inside lane on the hairpin. It's a lot of sand. Let's take a look. Gordon gets in.
Just looks like he got it up into the berm right there. And Ricky Johnson says, excuse me, Mr. Gordon, I'm coming on through. I want to get my first victory of the season.
Yeah, Robbie had a bit of a problem, and then Ricky made sure that the problem was one that was substantial enough that he could get through. But he was right there. He had to go. They made contact. Gordon suffers the problem. Ricky Johnson out in front, and now Rob Mack, just like we saw at the beginning of this event, putting pressure on Ricky Johnson.
And more importantly, with Robbie slipping back to third place, he had 25 championship points right there in his hand, but right now it appears that it's going to be Ricky Johnson or maybe Rob Mack who comes home the winner.
Yeah, white flag is out. This is the last lap. Can Ricky Johnson make it four winners in four events? Rob Mack doesn't want it to happen. They make contact as they head to the chute, and it is tight. Johnson pulling out just a little bit. A couple of corners left. McCaffrey hard on it as they head down into the hairpin. That's where Gordon had his problem.
Absolutely, and more contact as Ricky Johnson gets a little squirrely, and now there's a battle for the lead. Rob Mack up and over, and what a move over that ramp.
Rob McCaffrey gets it, and Rob McCaffrey through the final corner. Rob McCaffrey on two wheels. McCaffrey takes the victory. The first two-time winner in the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series, and it was intense.
Now that is what this stuff is all about, folks. What a fantastic move over that metal ramp.
And Rob McCaffrey is climbing out of his truck out on the racetrack. You don't think that that is one happy winner? Look at him.
What a move and what a finish to this thing. And who would have thought Rob Mack was going to end up winning this thing? At one point, it looked like Ricky Johnson running away with it. Then Robbie Gordon takes over. And then, wow, what a final four laps that was.
Impressive. Rob McCaffrey makes it two wins on the season. He steals it from Ricky Johnson. This is what Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks is all about. Qualcomm Stadium, site of round four of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series. The checkered flag has fallen. There was enough excitement in just the final three laps to fill the weekend. Robbie Gordon led with just a couple of laps to go, but Ricky Johnson gets into the back of him and takes over the lead.
And it looked like Ricky was going to get a win, but what a finish.
Rob McCaffrey gets by Ricky Johnson right at the checkered flag. Johnson suffered a flat right rear tire. And Rob McCaffrey takes the victory, the second on the season for him. He stopped halfway around the racetrack, gets out, waves to the fans. Yeah, you don't think he was happy? That's going to do good things in the championship as well. Let's take a look at the results. McCaffrey with the victory, like we said. Ricky Johnson, great run for him. He hadn't even been here for most of the weekend.
Hadn't even seen the track, so came out here, did a great job. Robbie Gordon coming home third. Ari Lyondyke Jr. continuing to improve, but look at Lalo Laguna, sixth place. What a comeback for that kid who got banged up early on.
Yeah, and you talk about a kid. Look a little back, further back. Back in 10th and then in 14th, Jarrett Brooks and Sheldon Creek, 15 years old. They made their debut in the series this weekend. Well, let's hear from our winner with Kelly Stavis.
Robin climbing out of his truck after an unbelievable finish. Rob getting it done in the final moments of this race. Talk about getting that last second move on Ricky.
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, this trucks are unbelievable. You know, everything that Robbie Gordon's done with SSD, getting these trucks back here in these stadiums, you know, it's absolutely awesome. You know, you got to go tell your friends. We'll be back here in 2 weeks doing this again, and it's awesome. It's unbelievable. Is it going over the thing today?
Yeah.
You know, it's incredible. You know, Ricky, Robbie, you know, we all raced Mickey Thompson back in the day, and, you know, it's absolutely incredible. You know, we were, you know, out there struggling, you know, just trying to we were struggling out there and trying to stay with these guys, and finally we started getting close to them, and it was time to go. Once Robbie got screwed up and Ricky, you know, we were just trying to get him down. I don't know, I see he has a flat tire right now, so maybe that happened. But, you know, Traxxas, you know, they're the fastest name in remote control. And, you know, these trucks are just as fun as driving a remote control truck. So thank you guys all for coming out here, and we'll be back here in 2 weeks. Go tell all your buddies and get your butts back in these seats in 2 weeks.
Congratulations, Rob.
Thank you.
Well, if it's anything like tonight, you certainly want to come back in 2 weeks to watch it. And we said that championship, this win is good for his championship hopes, and it certainly is. He came in with just a 2-point advantage over Robbie Gordon. He extends that to 10.
Yeah, because as we talked about earlier, 25 points for Rob McCaffrey getting the victory. And you know, when we come back here, Brian, for the second time here in San Diego, track's going to be different, so it should be very interesting.
And Justin Lofton dropped back with some of his problems today, and you look a little bit further back. Lalo Laguna, we talked about the good finish he had. moves up in the points a little bit, so he's holding on. We still have a long way to go. Just four rounds finished, eight to go, and you think about the championship, it's great. You see that it just takes one event, Chuck, to change the complexion. You said it, we're going to be back in 2 weeks, but
it's going to be a different racetrack, so who knows. But again, Rob back getting the second victory of the year, so Lofton didn't have the night he wanted, but to Robbie right there in the thick of it. But again, Ricky Johnson showing why he's Ricky Johnson as well, coming home at seven.
Yeah, great stuff. Stadium Super Trucks. Great to be in San Diego. We'll be back in 2 weeks, and you'll see it right here on NBC Sports. More Stadium Super Trucks. Awesome stuff. Congratulations to Rob McCaffrey on his win tonight, the second of the season, as we said. For Kelly Stavis, Chuck Howard, I'm Brian Till. Thanks for joining us for round four of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series from San Diego. We'll see you in 2 weeks right here. Make sure you join us. So long, everyone.
For round four of Stadium Super Trucks, the main event just moments away, and we've got some great news. At the back of the field, you will see number 17, Lala Laguna. He had a nasty crash in his heat race when his brakes locked up going off the front jump. He came up short. There was damage to the truck. It looked like there was damage to Lala, but I saw moments later he was actually out of his truck and smiling back in the paddock. His crew hard at work. They had to fix a broken lower control arm, the suspension, and some damage to the front cage, but they got it all back together in time to have him out here for the main event. So Lala Laguna all smiles as he heads into this main event, Brian.
Well, thanks, Kelly. That's good news for Lala Laguna to be back in. It'll be interesting to see if that truck is in good shape to race with. This is how they'll line up. Ricky Johnson, Rob McCaffrey on the front row. That's some strength there, Chuck.
There's some veterans there, a lot of victories, but I'm going to keep an eye on Justin Lofton, of course. He's red hot, wants to get back on the podium with a victory. And, of course, those passing points.
Well, absolutely. Robbie Gordon in the 7 truck, back in 7th. You look through this top 7, there is some serious, serious talent there. Look a little further back. The first of our 15-year-olds, Sheldon Creed in 8th. Jarrett Brooks, they're going to be 8th and 9th. And those two, spectacular in their debut. Struggled a little bit, made some rookie mistakes, let's say.
Mistakes late, but I'm going to keep my eye on those guys. And Creed, I think, has a really good truck. And Brooks, they both showed very well in their heat races. So keep an eye on those guys.
On board with Justin Lofton, he'll bring us some good looks. There's Robbie Gordon. And it'll be Ricky Johnson who leads the field to green. And here we go, the final, the main event. From here in San Diego, Qualcomm Stadium, Ricky Johnson across the line, and we are racing. Be interesting to see who selects it. Ricky Johnson goes right, and you saw Rob McCaffrey go left with that first option. They're going to come back together here as McCaffrey comes over the Toyo crossover. They should come back together. Ricky Johnson holds on to the lead. BJ Jones gets tagged by Justin Lofton. And already down the chute, things getting busy.
Yeah, Ricky Johnson took that outside lane through the sand pits. And as we saw in the heat races, it appeared that the Toyo crossover was just a little bit quicker. But Ricky Johnson has a pretty quick race truck in that yellow Jegs number 5.
Very quick, and a problem for one of the other competitors. I believe it's the 77, Jarrett Brooks, coming to the start-finish line, but it did not impede Ricky Johnson. And Rob McCaffrey is giving chase big time. That orange number panel signifying he leads the championship, but it's Ricky Johnson that leads the race.
And McCaffrey taking that Toyo crossover again, and Johnson getting through the sand pits, increasing that lead.
Wow, Rob McCaffrey using every bit of road down at the hairpin. Johnson with the inside option. McCaffrey's going to take a little bicycle there by McCaffrey. And Johnson just pulling out little bits at a time, a problem. You saw further back, PJ Jones in the black 98. Justin Lofton on the move forward.
Right there in the back of the field, PJ Jones winning his heat race, trying to get onto the back bumper of Justin Lofton as they head to the Toyo crossover.
Lofton in his Solar City truck over the jump, over the crossover. PJ Jones a short distance back, that black 98. Remember, he won heat number 2. And was that Matney that he just went past that had a problem? Yeah, Justin Matney with a problem on the backside of the course. Jones trying to claw down on Justin Lofton down the chute.
Yeah, it doesn't appear that Jones is making much ground on him, but he's staying right there. And right there, he makes some ground on him as they hit the hairpin. And now heading through the rhythm section is Lofton. Caught some serious air off that one jump heading into the rhythm section.
PJ not afraid to lean on him at all. That fiberglass and Kevlar reinforced bodywork really starting to put it on the back of Lofton. Robbie Gordon closing in on that duo as well.
Robbie starting seventh in this main event here. He doesn't seem to be gaining much ground, but he did win the last chance qualifier, which I know shows that he's got a decent race truck.
Even Gordon talking about this is a tough layout. He said, I may have made this one a little too difficult. The other thing to note, this main a lot longer than any of the heat races, 20 laps, and it is physically abusing. The guy's saying this has been the most difficult track as far as physical goes. It really wears you out, and they're going to have to do 20 laps.
Well, with this track and at Qualcomm, it's a tight confine, the tightest track we've had so far this season, and so these guys don't have any chance to take a break.
Ricky Johnson leading over Rob McCracken, then Lofton, PJ Jones, Robbie Gordon. That is the top five with four laps in the books, and there's a look at your leader.
Ricky Johnson, just unbelievable. Didn't make it here for qualifying, but he's leading this thing. Didn't see this racetrack till today.
Well, and that's what's impressive. We missed that yellow number five, the Jegs truck, in practice. It, as you said, he didn't get to see the track, and that's the mark of somebody who's done what Ricky Johnson has done, whether it was on a motorcycle or in a race car. He is a champion. He's smart. He read the track, and man, he is fast today, Kelly.
He told me afterward that once he found out just how tough this track was and how physically demanding, he said, forget this. I don't want any part of that last chance qualifier.
And a good call. I mean, you want to be as fresh as you possibly can, which is impressive when you think about Justin Lofton running in third. Remember, he won a race earlier today, an off-road race through the desert, a 300-mile race, sharing driving duties with some family members. But still, a lot of travel for Justin Lofton, and he's hanging in there in third. But McCracken and Ricky Johnson have pulled away. There's Justin Lofton.
Yeah, Justin in that Solar City-sponsored number six truck. And Justin hanging in there in third position, but doesn't seem to be making up much ground on Rob McCracken.
Things clean through the first six laps here, and that's been amazing because there's been a lot of problems on this tight racetrack here at Qualcomm Stadium. You ride on board with Justin Lofton, shifting gears, he'll grab the brake as he comes to this next corner, locks the rear tires for just an instant, helps the truck turn, and then 650 horsepower back to the ground.
And there's Rob McCracken in that Traxxas number 21, grinding and doing it. And I mean, that guy, as you see the stat right there, has won 20 championships in his racing career, including off-road, motocross, and you name it. Two of the sports premier drivers right here on NBC Sports Network. So enjoy it, folks.
Think about Rob McCracken, over 200 victories. He is right there on the back of Ricky Johnson, that silver and blue Traxxas truck, number 21, Rob McCracken, and there is Lalo Laguna. And number 17, the Visit Mexico truck. We saw the problems for Laguna earlier. We talked about it just a little while ago. Great to see him back even in a truck after the hard hit when he came up short on that Toyo crossover.
Yeah, and we don't know if he just got the air knocked out of him. And we hear from the pits that he lost his brakes when he was jumping over the Toyo crossover, and we've got caution out on the speedway.
Caution for the first time with seven laps in the books. We'll take a quick break from Qualcomm Stadium, but we'll be back to more Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks right after this. Flag flies again here in the main event. Ricky Johnson leads the field, but this time it's Robbie Gordon right behind him. Rob McCracken in third, and Gordon is putting pressure on from the drop of the green.
And PJ Jones hanging in there. What is he earlier on? He decides to follow Ricky Johnson this time. I think for the first time in this main event, Johnson up and over the Toyo crossover.
Yeah, Johnson went left, took the Toyo crossover. It didn't work for anyone else. It doesn't work for him. And Robbie Gordon goes to the lead. Ricky Johnson back to second. Rob McCracken holds on to third. And Johnson has to be thinking, why did I just do that? I was so successful with the right-hand option. Why did I change?
And now the in-car from Ricky Johnson, and he's got a windshield full of that orange number 7 speed energy of Robbie Gordon as Robbie heads up and over the Pro Comp.
Big championship implications here. Gordon just a single marker back after qualifying from Rob McCracken in the championship, and now he's two positions.
San Diego, California is known as a laid-back city where the sand, the surf, and water sports are just a part of city life. But today at Qualcomm Stadium, sand and dirt has been molded into more than castles on the beach, and the jumps aren't just off the back of a Pacific Ocean wave. It's time for high-flying, high-horsepower stadium off-road racing as we bring you round 4 of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series on the NBC Sports Network. Hello, everyone. I'm Brian Till, and welcome to today's coverage. Joining me up top is Motorsports Insider and broadcaster Chuck Howard, as well as Kelly Stavis, trackside. Now, after 3 rounds in the inaugural season, the points look like this. Rob McCracken holding on to the slimmest of championship leads, Chuck.
Well, Brian, Rob Mack was our winner in Phoenix. Robbie Gordon, though, he's been on fire. Winner 2 weeks ago in L.A., won qualifying here in San Diego. Justin Lofton looking to overtake both of those guys here in San Diego tonight.
Yeah, Lofton and P.J. Jones having a good battle for third. And for more on Justin Lofton, here's Kelly.
Brian, even though Rob McCracken and Robbie Gordon are neck and neck for the championship lead, don't count out Justin Lofton. The NASCAR truck driver sits third in the point standings and has proven to be just as quick, if not quicker, than the guys he trails. He was our fastest qualifier at the season opener in Phoenix, but his results haven't always reflected his talent. Even though he won at Long Beach, he finished 11th in Phoenix and 9th in Los Angeles. Now, with a quarter of the season already behind us, Justin says he's definitely looking at those points, and he wants to be more consistent. He said he's got to take less of a Ricky Bobby if you're not first or last approach. Now, Justin has just arrived in San Diego from a desert race out in Nevada. Now, the good news for him is that he won his class. It was a great day. The bad news is he's already raced more than 100 miles, and he admits he's tired, and there's certainly no room for error here in San Diego. So we'll see if fatigue plays a factor for Lofton tonight.
Well, thanks, Kelly. Justin Lofton certainly has his work cut out for him. Trucks already heading into the stadium. If you're new to the Super Truck Series, here is what is in store today. Each weekend of competition, qualifying sets the field for the first of 2 heat races, with the top 3 in each heat moving directly to the main event. And then all the other finishers in each heat will meet in a last chance qualifying race. That will set the remainder of the field for the final event. $40,000 to the winner of tonight's event. $500,000 goes to the series champion. And heat number 1 about to get underway. It'll be Ari Leyendyk who brings the field down. This is how they will start. Notice Robbie Gordon at the back. He was the pole sitter, Chuck, but what does that get you?
You go back to the last place to start the heat number 1, but that's what makes this stuff fun.
It's an inverted order here. So Robbie Gordon the quickest of the drivers here in this heat. Ari Leyendyk the slowest. You also saw the 21 orange number plate. Mike McCracken in, and we're green. We're racing heat number 1 underway. Hold on. Through the first of the crossover jumps, the Pro Comp crossover, Leyendyk leads the field.
Well, Ari Leyendyk won heat number 1 in L.A. 2 weeks ago, got out front. He took a different turn, as did Justin Lofton, taking crossover right there, but Ari building a lead.
You've got the Toyo crossover jump, or you can opt for the West Coast sand pit, and now
and that's a San Diego traffic jam right there, Brian.
You got to come back down and get the truck down the chute, over the step up, and now the next of 2 options into the hairpin. Leyendyk chooses the tighter inside option. Ward right behind him, and here we go again.
And Mike Jenkins taking the lead as he goes over that step up. But look out, Justin Lofton in the Solar City white and green truck right on his tail.
Jeff Ward got the worst of all of this as Mike Jenkins now gets shoved out of the way by Justin Lofton. Lofton takes the lead, and he'll lead at the end of the first lap and over the Pro Comp crossover.
Yes, indeed. And everybody safely through that turn heading up the Pro Comp crossover. Yesterday in practice, there was a lot of concern that folks were going to have trouble, but everybody safely through.
Lofton taking the Pro Comp crossover, takes the jump, and a problem for Robbie Gordon, who has spun on track, but not for Justin Lofton. Now down the chute, trouble everywhere. Guys trying to get a handle on this track, but Lofton takes the outside at the hairpin. Rob McCaffrey takes the inside option, and now comes the rhythm section side by side.
That's a good old-fashioned drag race there. And earlier in the show, you heard Kelly mention that Justin Lofton raced earlier in the day, but he's not showing any signs so far of any fatigue.
Well, so did Rob McCaffrey right behind him. So these two drivers already warmed up, let's say. But they are exhausted. They both take the right-hand option and through the West Coast sand pit.
Absolutely. Up and over goes Lofton, heading to the second step up. Going to make that sharp turn, heading down the chute. A good battle at the top of the field right here.
Kelly.
Well, while it seemed that Justin Lofton had some time to get settled in here from his race in Nevada, Rob McCaffrey arrived just moments before the start of this heat race. He'll compete in seven different off-road vehicles this year. He said every time he gets into one, it takes him about 5 minutes to sort of locate the ignition switch, locate the shifter, go through the motions before he feels like he's at home again. Well, I'm not even sure if he had 5 minutes before the start of this heat race.
I'll tell you what, he and Justin Lofton are having quite the go of it, and now McCaffrey has taken the right-hand option, and Lofton has gone over the Toyo crossover, I should say, and they come out bumper to bumper down the chute.
And surprised to see so many drivers taking that Toyo crossover tonight, Brian, because yesterday in practice, pretty much nobody wanted to do it.
And now they split him again at the hairpin. McCaffrey in the inside in that silver and blue tracks his truck. Lofton in the white takes the lead again, but this is the way they've run lap after lap. Solar City on board the side of that truck, the SST for Justin Lofton, and over the Pro Comp crossover. You ride on board, you see him grab that handbrake, Chuck, that locks the rear brakes, helps him turn the truck.
Absolutely, you can use your foot pedal, but these guys, when they hit that turn, like to use that handbrake to whip that rear end around.
And one more time, they've taken different options. Lofton still in front of McCaffrey, but it's close.
One of the biggest surprises in this field, Brian, is Sheldon Creed, number 74. A 15-year-old high school student from California, has over 20 first-place finishes in off-road racing. He's racing the big boys tonight, qualified third, and holding his own so far.
Yeah, he's third, and you're shot right there, running just behind Justin Lofton and Rob McCaffrey, and you cannot say enough for this young man. Doing a great job. Like you said, 15 years old. I talked to him earlier, he said, I just got my learner's permit the other day, but I got to tell you, I think I drive better in the race truck than I do on the street right now.
Well, let's watch him take the Toyo crossover, and he lands it cleanly.
Like a pro, and the battle still raging on in front. Justin Lofton in the white Solar City SST. One more time, he and Rob McCaffrey split the options down at the hairpin. McCaffrey always comes out in front, but Justin Lofton gets the run off the corner.
Brian, we talked about Sheldon Creed, the future, the youth of this series, but let's talk about Jeff Ward. We all know about his accolades from his years of motocross and supercross, and right there in the number four stadium super truck, Jeff Ward, having a pretty good run tonight, fourth place right now.
Well, and Ward has been fast all year long. He just hasn't had good luck. A fourth at Phoenix, then eighth at Long Beach, 12th at the Coliseum when he had a flat tire. So he's been quick, as you would expect that he would, but he just needs to get Lady Luck on his side.
Robbie Gordon in fifth position. He won the pole position, if you will, here in San Diego on Friday. And Robbie got hung up earlier in this heat race, digging in there, hanging in there in fifth, but he doesn't seem to be gaining much ground on Jeff Ward.
Well, he gained ground on Rob McCaffrey with his victory last time out at the Coliseum. And Gordon needs to close a little bit. He picked up a point for being on the pole. You mentioned that earlier, but he's lagging back that problem early, as you said, being shown in fifth right now. It's Lofton, McCaffrey, and Creed, then Ward, with seven laps in the books right now.
Well, back up front, as they head down the chute, it's Justin Lofton.
And look at Sheldon Creed. He is right there, really closing in on our two leaders.
Well, what a dream this must be for this kid, thinking of in that cockpit, if you will, seeing Rob McCaffrey right ahead and Justin Lofton. Oh, but trouble.
Creed out of the ballpark, comes off of the hairpin, gets up on the concrete barrier, and literally flies out of the track. And there is no way for him to get back in, Chuck. That's the problem.
And, folks, if these guys aren't impeding the racetrack at all, we're not going to see a caution. But what a disappointing way to end Sheldon Creed's debut tonight. But folks knew he was here, and he'll have a chance to come back in the last chance qualifier.
Just got crossed up on the step up into the rhythm section, got up on that concrete barrier and out of the ballpark. You ride with Lofton. You see him grab the handbrake there to help turn the truck as he now heads through the rhythm section. Well, past the ProComp crossover and then over the steel ramp.
Well, there was not much rhythm left to that area down there, Brian, but here comes Justin Lofton, one lap to go.
White flag out, Lofton over the crossover, and a pretty hard landing.
Almost went over on that landing.
And he takes the left-hand option, McCaffrey taking the right-hand option, seeing if he can do anything. It's pretty much the way they've run it all night tonight. And one more time, McCaffrey will be right there on the back bumper, but not close enough to do anything as Lofton heads down the chute for the last time.
Well, in practice here at San Diego, Brian, the drivers weren't taking that Toyo crossover too much, but it looks like tonight that's going to be your way to gain on the rest of the field, or at the very least, stay out in front like Justin Lofton has as he heads to the checkered flag.
Lofton around the last corner. He'll return to victory circle. Justin Lofton claims heat number one here in San Diego. Congratulations to Justin Lofton for his heat win in number one. Rob McCaffrey right behind him, though. It was close. Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks on NBC. Heat two coming up. Make sure you don't miss a lap. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Qualcomm Stadium. Brian Till and Chuck Howard with you. And earlier we talked about the championship. And Chuck, I think the thing that's important to note is these drivers have multiple ways to score points on the weekend.
I'll say there's a myriad of ways to win points here at the Stadium Super Trucks. 25 points to win the main event. You can also garner 1 point by winning the qualifying session on Friday, 3 points by leading the most laps, and we've got a real cool thing here. It's called passing points. You get a point for every position you gain in the main event, so that's pretty cool.
Number two about to get underway, and up front it'll be Justin Matney in the number eight. Matney will lead the field off, and Ricky Johnson way back in the back in his yellow number five. Johnson not able to qualify, and that had to be disappointing for him because he's another one of those drivers like Jeff Ward, whom we talked about earlier. Very quick, just bad luck.
Absolutely. Here we go. Green flag, heat number two. Matney leading him to the green flag.
To the green flag, and a little problem behind. Adrian Chinney in that bright orange number 10 gets hung up, but PJ Jones says, thank you very much, I'll go by, and Matney takes the right-hand option. PJ Jones around the left side option, the Toyo crossover, and they should meet down at the far end. Jones trying to close down. You see him coming out of the corner of the screen there, and Matney with a problem. He shoots wide, Jones is wide, and Adrian Chinney.
Another California traffic jam, and some serious contact in the back of the field as Johnson and Nick Baumgartner got together.
And right now, Adrian Chinney on the outside option, PJ Jones the inside option, through the rhythm section, and they are rubbing. And you ride on board with Ricky Johnson over the steel jump.
Absolutely, here's Ricky Johnson. As you can see, as Brian mentioned in the previous heat, that handbrake these guys use as they make these turns to whip that back end around. Adrian Chinney slow, but he makes it over. But again, in car with Ricky Johnson. What an awesome view that is.
Johnson trying to chase down the 77 right in front of him. That is Jarrett Brooks, the other 15-year-old in the field.
And Jarrett Brooks, 15 years old. And more on that young man as we go on here in heat number two.
Look at PJ Jones leading right now, right behind him. Jarrett Brooks beginning to close the distance. And there's Ricky Johnson in that bright yellow Jegs truck. There's Jarrett. And you're really kind of going to school on PJ Jones in front of him right now. Johnson hanging in there, and you got to take your hat off to Ricky Johnson. He was doing some instructing for the U.S. military, trying to help them with some of their off-road skills, and that's about all we'll say there, just except for the fact that RJ wasn't here the last couple of days, so he is learning right now as he drives, as he races. PJ Jones out in front, then Jarrett Brooks, then Ricky Johnson. That is your top three. Brooks by Johnson.
And P.J. Jones, last 2 weeks ago in Los Angeles, a heat winner. And this guy is getting better each and every week as he heads to the rhythm section, heads down the fast portion of that chute, taking the metal ramp, and he whips it around as we continue on here in heat number two.
Well, we joked about P.J. being on his head more than any other driver, but you said it. He's really gotten a handle on these stadium super trucks. Found a victory in a heat race, running well here. So is Jarrett Brooks. You cannot say enough about this young man.
Well, as I mentioned, 15 years old, just like Sheldon Creed. He's out of California, has his driver's permit, but no license. And he's run a lot of off-road, and he's hanging in there and putting on a heck of a show all the way up to second place, Jarrett Brooks of the Symmetry Electric Stadium Super Truck.
Oh, and a little bicycle there around the outside. Ricky Johnson takes the position back, but only for a moment. And Brooks back in the throttle, 650 horsepower, trying to get that to the ground. And Johnson now right behind him, a little wipe of the visor there so we can see back on the bumper of Jarrett Brooks.
Nick Baumgartner back in the field as he tries to track down Justin Matney, and Baumgartner in fifth position. And Nick is another one of these guys, kind of like PJ Jones, who is constantly and kind of gotten better each and every week. The number 12 Pure Michigan truck of Nick Baumgartner.
Certainly no fear on the part of Baumgartner. He is a Winter X Games snowboard cross driver and very experienced, very brave, and a problem on the racetrack. The red is out.
Well, what happened, and we'll see it, I think, in a minute here, Brian, but Lalu Laguna had some trouble with the Toyo crossover. As you can see, that visitormexico.com, the front end of that vehicle, he's going to have to head back to the pits.
Truck's lined up. It's PJ Jones leading right now, and that impressive 15-year-old Jarrett Brooks right behind him, and we'll go back to green. They'll come through the rhythm section, and they'll get the green flag as they come back around to the first of the crossovers.
And the green flag is out, and PJ Jones, as I mentioned earlier on, getting better each and every week. Heat winner in Los Angeles 2 weeks ago. And this is another driver in this series, Brian, a guy that can drive anything. He's run NASCAR Sprint Cups, had a top 10 finish in NASCAR Nationwide, sports car winner. He's raced in Baja, and all those years of experience pretty much racing everything paying off as PJ Jones still out P1.
And look at Ricky Johnson in that yellow Jegs machine, trying to move forward, trying to get back past Jarrett Brooks. The impressive youngster right there in the white 77 in front, running second. It's Jones, Brooks, Johnson, and then Matney, who starts out in front. And he has passed several trucks to get there, so we'll get points for those as well. Robbie Gordon having an evening of it. It'll be interesting to see. Ricky Johnson has been so quick. Can he shake off that error in judgment? I say error in judgment. Now, you try anything as a race car driver to get a position, but can he calm back down and charge back to the front?
It may not have been an error in judgment. It may have just been a really good move by Robbie Gordon.
Well, there you go. Good point. McCaffrey slipping back just a little bit. Rob McCaffrey, another one of those drivers, ran the Silver State 300. He and Justin Lofton did. And they have to be fatigued. They have to be tired. Not only the race, but the travel to and from. He's doing a good job of holding on. Gordon maintains about the same lead that he had before as you look at PJ Jones running fourth right now.
And PJ, it appeared he was going to gain on Rob McCaffrey at that restart, but he's lost a little ground. But hanging in there nonetheless, going to be a decent points night for PJ.
Well, we've talked about the improvement that PJ has shown over the first three rounds. He showed even more improvement by winning a heat race here. The second heat, now running well into the top five. So PJ really good getting a handle on these stadium super trucks. Look at it pick up that right front as he goes around the horseshoe on the way to the ProCom crossover.
Rob McCaffrey in third position, trailing Ricky Johnson as Robbie Gordon continues to increase his lead on Ricky Johnson. But Rob trying to do everything he can. Big Mac trying to get back up in there. But as of right now, it'll be a podium finish for Mac.
And a driver not having the day that he wanted is Justin Lofton, who just pulled out of the stadium. As you look at Rob McCaffrey still trying to hold on. And McCaffrey, such a veteran, has won so many times. He knows how to win a championship. And I'm thinking that right now he may be saying, I've got a third place truck. I'm going to leave here with those third place points. I'm certainly not going to give those away by throwing this away.
Well, last lap by, Ricky Johnson was the quickest, trying to gain on Robbie, and it appears that perhaps he is gaining slightly.
He's going to have to close down a lot more as they head down the chute. Beginning to pull out, PJ Jones trying to close in on the back of Rob Mack, and there's Robbie Gordon.
Well, as we mentioned at the top of the show as well, Brian, Robbie's been simply red hot. Started off in Phoenix, not getting the victory, but 2 weeks ago at the LA Coliseum, Robbie getting the win, was on the pole here, and right now out in front. Ari Lyandike Jr., haven't mentioned his name too much, currently in fifth position, and Ari's another guy like PJ Jones that slowly but surely is hanging in there and has performed very well, with the exception of the main at the LA Coliseum 2 weeks ago. Ari did win a heat race, so he's getting the hang of this stuff as well.
Yeah, from a guy who is a sports car and open wheel driver to dirt, he's doing a great job. Talk about a great job. Oh, and Gordon almost had a problem out on track as we're looking at Ari Lyandike. And Ricky Johnson has closed within 0.3 seconds the last time by, and he may be even closer this time. It was 2.1 seconds the last time at the line, 1.4 this time. Johnson can smell blood in the water, and Gordon trying to get past Lalo Laguna had an upset moment, and it allowed Ricky Johnson to close in even more. I said it was not a good evening for Justin Lofton. Kelly, what did he have?
Certainly not the way he wanted to end things after winning his heat race. Justin, we saw you get over on your lid early on. What happened?
Basically, just the track was coming up in some of the areas, got in the corner too hard. It's real unfortunate for everyone on the Solar City team. We had a decent run going. We weren't the fastest truck out there, but we definitely didn't deserve this. I think we broke an axle or something, and track is tough. I mean, it's fun, and it's going to be real abusive on equipment.
Thanks, Justin. Brian.
Well, yeah, not the 91. And remember, he had a great run with a victory. And you look at Ricky Johnson just sideways. And Lofton really had closed down in the championship. Didn't have a good run at the Coliseum and now struggled again here. And not of his own making, but that is off-road racing. It's punishing to both man and machine. And Justin Lofton got the worst of it here. Gordon kind of beginning to pull out again. And it was traffic that helped create that gap. Adrian Chinney was in between Gordon and Ricky Johnson the last lap, and it really allowed Gordon to pull out a little bit over Johnson. It'll be interesting to see. Ricky can close it back down. 16 laps down, 4 to go.
Well, it looks like Robbie's really getting into a good rhythm right here. And as you mentioned, Ricky Johnson got tied up with Adrian Chinney. That's where he lost some time in that sand pit. And you wonder at this stage of the evening now if Ricky Johnson, if fatigue is setting in.
Johnson pushing as hard as he can. Now putting pressure on Ricky Johnson. Johnson with a big bicycle, and they get hung up. And oh, PJ Jones just on the outside lane. He goes over, and PJ Jones has become a turtle.
And another caution as Robbie had a huge lead. And what a huge break for Johnson and McEachran because of PJ Jones' misfortune, however.
How do you get past Robbie Gordon? We're about to find out. The green flag flies, and here we go.
Yeah, I'd have to think he's gonna just try whatever Robbie does, he does, until maybe the final lap, but just gamble, and maybe he'll take the Toyo crossover on lap with the final lap to go.
Through the first crossover, and here's decision time. Gordon out with a bit of a bicycle. The first four trucks go right, and Gordon with a near miss there as he got the big bicycle going through that right-hand option, and Ricky Johnson stays right with him. Rob McCaffrey in third. down the chute, into the hairpin, inside option for Gordon, for Johnson, and McCaffrey. It's follow the leader.
And what a treat for off-road racing fans, folks. Look at that. Robbie Gordon on top as Rob Mack almost lost it in third place, but hung on to it.
The rhythm section doesn't have a lot of rhythm to it right now. It's getting really rutted up, and McCaffrey drops back a little bit. But Ricky Johnson still trying to hold on to the back of Robbie Gordon. Time is slipping away, 17 laps down, 20 laps in this main event. And if Johnson's going to get something done, he needs to get it done soon.
Well, I'd have to think, like I mentioned, he's going to have to gamble with one lap to go because Robbie's obviously going to take that sand pit every time.
Well, you got to think Gordon will take
Robbie
the inside.
Has problems.
Gordon with a problem in the hairpin. And Johnson by Gordon up on the K-rail. And Ricky Johnson slips by Gordon back to third.
Well, that's a mistake that you would never think you'd see a veteran like Robbie do.
So rutted up down there in the inside lane on the hairpin. It's a lot of sand. Let's take a look. Gordon gets in.
Just looks like he got it up into the berm right there. And Ricky Johnson says, excuse me, Mr. Gordon, I'm coming on through. I want to get my first victory of the season.
Yeah, Robbie had a bit of a problem, and then Ricky made sure that the problem was one that was substantial enough that he could get through. But he was right there. He had to go. They made contact. Gordon suffers the problem. Ricky Johnson out in front, and now Rob Mack, just like we saw at the beginning of this event, putting pressure on Ricky Johnson.
And more importantly, with Robbie slipping back to third place, he had 25 championship points right there in his hand, but right now it appears that it's going to be Ricky Johnson or maybe Rob Mack who comes home the winner.
Yeah, white flag is out. This is the last lap. Can Ricky Johnson make it four winners in four events? Rob Mack doesn't want it to happen. They make contact as they head to the chute. And it is tight. Johnson pulling out just a little bit. A couple of corners left. McCaffrey hard on it as they head down into the hairpin. That's where Gordon had his problem.
Absolutely. And more contact as Ricky Johnson gets a little squirrely. And now there's a battle for the lead. Rob Mack up and over. And what a move over that ramp.
Rob McCaffrey gets it. And Rob McCaffrey through the final corner. Rob McCaffrey on two wheels. McCaffrey takes the victory. The first two-time winner in the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series, and it was intense.
Now that is what this stuff is all about, folks. What a fantastic move over that metal ramp.
And Rob McCaffrey is climbing out of his truck out on the racetrack. You don't think that that is one happy winner? Look at him.
What a move and what a finish to this thing. And who would have thought Rob Mack was going to end up winning this thing? At one point, it looked like Ricky Johnson running away with it. Then Robbie Gordon takes over. And then, wow.
Started on the pole, Justin Matney in the black number 8. And look at this, PJ Jones and Ricky Johnson banging doors. And Jones, a slide job.
And that is some fantastic racing. And we saw from the in-car camera, Ricky Johnson took that hairpin turn and gained some advantage. But PJ Jones has a pretty fast race truck.
PJ Jones comfortably in the lead.
Yes, indeed. Ricky Johnson right there. And it looks like PJ can just kind of cruise home now as he's on the final lap, heading down the chute. Ricky Johnson still in second. And there's Justin Matney hanging in there in third place. So it looks like he's going to have a nice starting spot for the main as well.
And that's big for Matney. He needed a good finish. As PJ Jones through the rhythm section one last time. Matney working his way around. It's still Jones, Johnson, and Matney. Jones just one more corner across the line, and it will be PJ Jones wins heat number 2 in San Diego.
Two races in a row. It's PJ Jones. And that's got to be huge for his confidence, building more and more. Third place finish for PJ at the LA Coliseum. And, you know, a guy that many folks thought maybe not, might not be a threat to win this $500,000 season-ending championship, he's going to be right there in the thick of things if he keeps running like that, Brian.
For the second race weekend in a row, PJ Jones wins a heat race in the Stadium Super Truck Series. Question is, when will he win a main event? We'll find out if he can do it from here at Qualcomm. Plenty more to come.
Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks is brought to you by ProComp, off-road driven. By Traxxas, the fastest name in radio control. And by Speed Energy, a healthier, faster choice of energy. Fuel the need. With both heat races done, it's time for last chance qualifier. Here's how they lined up to start. Robbie Gordon on pole.
We're not supposed to see Robbie Gordon second in the points heading in the last chance qualifier, but there he was.
There he was, and you see the number 74, the black truck, being driven by Sheldon Creed, a 15-year-old. He was impressive. Nick Baumgartner having a good run. Ari Lyon-Dyke Jr., but it was Robbie Gordon having it all his way out in front.
Yeah, absolutely. He got out front early, pretty much stayed there.
Mike Jenkins with a problem on one of the inside options, but Adrian Chinney, turtle.
Yeah, the wild man with some serious problems for sure.
The guy that did not have a problem was Robbie Gordon from the drop of the green. He was strong. Lyon-Dyke Jr. had a good run, but in the end, Robbie Gordon around the final corner takes the checkered flag and takes the victory in the LCQ.
The LCQ setting position 7 through 14 for the main event.
Yeah, because remember the top three in each of the heats, they go directly to the final. Everybody else gets set by the LCQ, but then a little twist. See the four Traxxas bodies, they turn them over, there's a number. Well, number four today, that means the top four positions get inverted. If you were on the pole, you're gonna start fourth, and that's exactly what happens. So when you take a look at the grid and how they'll start for the main event, Ricky Johnson starts from the pole.
And you mentioned PJ Jones and Justin Lofton, they won their heat races. It gets flip-flopped, so they start 3 and 4.
And Rob McCachran, championship points leader, starts outside the front row. We talked about Sheldon Creed, Jarrett Brooks, another 15-year-old.
Add their ages up, doesn't even match Robbie Gordon's 44.
Yeah, impressive stuff. Stadium Super Trucks, but remember, when you come to a Stadium Super Truck event, you also get trophy carts and super buggies. Well, trophy carts always putting on a great show. Miles Cheeks in the number one. A good run out in front, and there is always action, let's say, in trophy carts. Everybody walked away and had a great day. The guy with the best day, Miles Cheeks. He takes the victory, second of the season. He also won back in Phoenix, and so big celebrations from Miles Cheek. From trophy carts to super buggies, 1600cc four-cylinder engines, about 200 horsepower, and some excitement from the get-go. The number 48 up on the wall, that's Rick Welch. Bad day for him. And throughout the rest of the field, I mean, these guys pushing, banging, shoving, and throwing lots and lots of dirt. Take a look at this. Excuse me.
Throwing lots of dirt, and these guys put on a great show as well. See?
Another upside down. That was Rob Archibald with the problem, but in the end, the checkered flag falls on the number 12. So a good victory for Abdali Lopez. A winner in Super Buggy. Super Buggy, trophy carts. Well, guess what's next? You got it. Bigfoot Monster Trucks from Qualcomm Stadium. They're up next when we come back. Stadium Super Trucks on the NBC Sports Network. Stick around. Look out over San Diego Bay here in San Diego. Round four of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series underway. And great to be out here on the West Coast. The scenery absolutely beautiful, and the people as well. Super buggies, trophy carts, and Bigfoot monster trucks. The main event, Eric Swanson, only 17 years old, up against one of the best in the business, Dan Runty.
So we have a youngster in the series going up against one of the biggest veterans, one of the most well-known guys in Bigfoot monster truck racing, Dan Runty. But what a huge night for that youngster, Eric Swanson.
Look at that. Great jump by Swanson. Runty actually holds the distance record, a world record for jumping one of these monster trucks. And in the end, it was one final jump for Runty. It takes the victory as Eric Swanson has some type of a problem and is stopped there on course. A one-lap run, and Dan Runty takes the victory. Impressive stuff, though, for Swanson.
1,500 horsepower, 11,000 pounds.
And he's 17 years old. Good job.
Good job. We'll see more of him, that's for sure. And you'll see more Stadium Super Trucks. Take a look at the remaining schedule for 2013. Next race? Well, we're right back here in San Diego.
Next week, going to do it again, but with a different track, folks. And, hey, Nation's Heartland, Stadium Super Trucks coming your way. St. Louis, June 8th, and Soldier Field. For the first time in over 30 years, a motorsports event will be held in Soldier Field. So, folks, be a part of history.
And no better place to wrap it all up than Sam Boyd Stadium in Las Vegas in November. I'm sure there'll be a bit of a banquet and a celebration there.
You're already looking forward to it, aren't you?
I'm definitely looking forward to it. I mean, think about the exciting things we've seen and the exciting things we will see. You're going to see something exciting. The main event up next from Qualcomm Stadium, Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks. Main event coming your way.
Welcome back to Qualcomm Stadium.